Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. So in this video we'll be talking about how to start your career soon after completing your college as an AME student. So guys, our today's video gonna be in two parts. The first part being your academic experience and the second part being your professional experience. Academic experience is what you get through your semesters, and professional experience is when you work as an on-job trainee in an organization or as a technician in scheduled and non-scheduled organizations. So I don't think I need to guide you about all the academic process that you went through, just like me. So let's move on towards getting your professional experience. Yes, I'm talking about your on-job training. Your on-job training is the first professional experience that you will get soon after stepping out from college. Your on-job training could be of 6 months duration or more than that, depending whether you take extension or not. And let me tell you, it has its own benefits. And soon after completing their on-job training, they try to get any sort of paid aviation experience. I repeat, aviation paid experience that helps them further in appearing in interviews where they get advantage over others. So now viewers, let's have a glance of all the basics that you need to know before me guiding you towards initiating your career. So now I will be telling you about scheduled organizations, non-scheduled organizations and MRO with the help of definitions and examples as you are seeing here. Talking about the MROs, there are basically two types: airline MROs and component MROs. MROs, maintenance and repair organizations, are basically CR approved organization responsible for aircraft maintenance, component maintenance or both. You might be thinking, why am I telling you all this? Now you will get to know why I was telling you all this. See, basically there are two ways of starting your career. The first is, either you could simply join an airline or a major MRO just by clearing off their interviews, which isn't meant for everyone for sure. But not to worry, you can also work in different component MROs for getting paid experience instead of sitting idle at home. Guys, there is no point in worrying when you can't make through an airline interview. It happened with me too. But still, there are 100 ways to make it up, because losing heart and your confidence won't give you nothing except a big gap on your CV. So don't waste your time and get yourself experience.
See, my whole point of telling you all this is just to make you feel confident and avoid you from thinking for the past that whatever happened. So stand up and don't regret for whatever happened, because it was not your fault. It was all about time and opportunities. So don't waste your time, stand up and go out and search for any component based MRO and work there for a particular amount of time. The MROs I'm talking about, for example, a wheel and brake shop, any component or galley equipment based MRO, work there for getting paid experience and you'll see you'll have your own benefits.
So these all are the opportunity for scheduled organizations. They conduct two types of interview, walk-in and calling. Some of them recruit on the basis of 6 months experience, while some of them have experience requirement of 1 or 2 years. And here we show the list of organization with required experience. Indigo recruits on the basis of 6 month experience, while GoAir requires 6 month experience or more. And here these are one of the few example of MROs where you could also make your career apart from scheduled airlines.
Here I have mentioned the experience requirement of different organization across India.
Guys, do follow our Instagram handle for more aviation updates and concept explanations, and also watch our previous videos on modules and on-job training.